Did you plant them in the fall or?
Yeah, the fall, and they were big.
Okay.
I'm gonna go back and I never saw a garden grow down there. It grows like a man.
Oh, you're saying they're bigger than usual?
I was just so excited, right?
And part of it could be the variety of garlic. Some types of garlic are smaller than others. It could be a lack of water. It could be a lot of things. Maybe the soil is just so good to it.
That was like, that's how it was. He has, I'll be growing garlic, also garlic festival. Got all the yellow board.
Yes.
That's all the favorite.
I should mention there are two.
I'm gonna take a picture
of this. Glasses of garlic. There's what they call hard net garlic and soft net garlic. If you ever buy the garlic that's in the braids, like the Italian garlic, that's actually soft net garlic. The stems on the garlic are soft and pliable, so you can braid them. The hard net garlic are very stiff. They sometimes they call it stiff net garlic too. So it's kind of like a stick coming out of the garlic. And that's actually the only kind that produces the scapes. The soft net garlics won't do that. And the garlic scapes, like I said, we do cut them off. We only have them for maybe 2 weeks because we want to cut them all off because we want the garlic. So if you ever see them next year, get them as you can because they'll be gone. Yep. So we grow both kinds of garlic, a soft and a hard, and we grow several varieties of each. The stiff necks do better in this area in the colder winters than the soft necks.
These
all clogs. Sorry? We'll harvest them in July, but we have to let them cure, so they probably won't be ready for sale until August.
I don't know if you mentioned, did you say, do you sell your stuff at the farmer's market also?
We sell some things at the farmer's market when we have extra. First pick goes to our CSA members.
Uh-huh.
So the people who order online or come to our house, they get first dibs basically, and then whatever's left over is sent to the market.
Cool.
Right now, when we do things, we usually drop off our leftover, our produce with the paid friends, because with the four kids, I have a hard time getting to the market. I don't know if anybody's on Facebook, but we're on Facebook. You can always find out what we're doing there. If you give me your email address, I can put you on our mailing list, and you actually get emails saying what's ready each week. And I can give you a link to our ordering website as well. Are you guys happy with the way everything tastes? If you look at the eggs, you can see the yolks are all really very, very yellow. That's because of their grass diet, the bugs and the insects, and it gives them a lot more. I can't remember the name of them, but that's why they're so yellow. Here are some pictures of our farm that Sarah printed out. If you guys want to look at them and pass them around. This picture is a picture of our cold frames. We do all our own transplants. We grow everything from seed. And we start them actually in our garage, which has become like a fake greenhouse. And then when they're ready to move out of the greenhouse, they put them into the cold frames or out on our porch, and then we take them out to the field. These are our three pigs this year. There's Bay and Abraham Lincoln. And Tiny was the runt of the litter. This is how your lettuce started out. This is head lettuce. Head lettuce we started as transplants, and then lettuce mix we actually seed in the field and cut it as a crop. These are some of the tools we use on our tractor to dig potatoes and plant potatoes. These are what we call potatoes. This is a picture of some of our produce. There's cabbage, some red scallions, green beans, kale. The sweet corn, we actually don't grow sweet corn. We work with another farmer who does a lot of sweet corn. They just do it very well. It's more worth my time to grow things like lettuce mix and some of those unusual things than sweet corn, because sweet corn takes up a whole lot of area. My neighbor grows GMO sweet corn, so it would kind of cause issues.
Ooh, wow.
We do a little bit, but I have friends. This is one of the things we do is typically we try to have special events at the farm and around Columbus Day every year. Well, we didn't do it last year, but we have a pumpkin picking party. We usually plant a field of pumpkins, and then all our CSA members come and pick pumpkins for their kids, and we have a dinner. Not yet, which is, I hope to eventually, because our school is just a half mile up the road. But I would like to have the school come down. There's been talk about starting a garden at the school, and we just haven't, I have four kids, and we just haven't quite gotten to that stage yet. but the thanks school group would like to come, they're more than welcome to. Yeah.
Have you already talked about your biggest pet challenge?
We talked a little bit, and I guess pest-wise, the biggest challenge would be flea beetles, which are, if you ever look at radishes or kale or anything in the brassica family, like broccoli, cauliflower, Brussels sprouts, mustard greens, you might find arugula. You find tiny little pinholes in the leaves, and those are from flea beetles. You really can't avoid them. So the only thing we really do is we put row cover down on our plants, on our crops, and that keeps a lot of the flea beetle pressure off. But to be honest, the best thing to do is to just wait until fall. The flea beetles are worse in the springtime than they are fall. And so we just plant the most of our greens in the fall. We do, in the good year, in the springtime when it's cool out, we do have a good greens crop, but this year it's been so hot and dry. Even if we had flea beetles, we still wouldn't have any greens because it's just the temperatures are all wrong. But really, I mean, really, to be honest, the flea beetles aren't really the issue this year. It's the lack of rain. Our soils are very dry. We have the sandy gravel soil, and they just don't hold water. So we're putting in irrigation this weekend as we speak. Have a good day. Do I have any food? Oh, fruit. We actually started this year. I planted strawberries, so we'll have to wait for next year for those. We planted raspberries and blackberries. Also have to wait for next year. We have some apples, but also we just eat those ourselves. We don't have a whole lot of them. We don't plant them this year. I'm going to plant blueberries next year. I have these in the ground already. I also planted asparagus, so that'll be ready in 3 years. We do have rhubarb, and that's ready now.
No cherries and cherry trees?
No, it's amazing. I don't understand why it must be the black cherry trees. But we are going to plant cherries. So like I said, we just start small, and even though we've gone to some that I'd like to kind of just work with what we've got and build up as we go. We're a small farm, just kind of going as we can. Each year there's something we do have the darkness.
I know Jessica's organized in Western New York Natural Organic
Farming.
What did you say?
That was the other thing.
Oh, yeah. I just wondered if you have any kind of, like, what your sense is of the community of, like, local farmers here. And, you know, I don't really know that.
Yeah, when I was talking about what we do with the community, one of the things I do is I organize a group of farmers in Western New York. And we get together, theoretically, a couple times a year. Whenever we can, and we sit down and we talk about what's going on in our farms, and we have a meal together. But a lot of it in between is just phone calls. Like, I can call my farmer friend out in Olean and ask him, well, how do you do irrigation? You know, it's really a lot of mentoring in there for me. But the farmers, there's a lot of farmers who are committed to growing naturally, committed to growing organically, committed to serving their local communities.
I don't want to.
Oh, okay.
It's actually a very strong
Thank you.
Group of farmers that may not look like it, at, you know, from top down because everybody's so busy doing their own little thing. But when you get in the wintertime, we're talking all the time. But we do support each other. I work with a couple of farms. When you ask about fruit, since we aren't producing our own fruit right now, what we do is we partner with Neighbors Acres in Kennedy, and they supply fruit for us. We buy it from them wholesale. We provide it for our share members. There are some stone fruit farms up towards Niagara County and Buffalo, Erie County, that provide like peaches and apples and those sorts of things. So we work with those farmers. Brookhaven Farm, I don't know if we're here to talk to them, but it's the last ones. They have poultry and a lot more eggs than we do. They also